All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Jim McDonald, the CEO of Kootenay Silver. And Jim, it's great to see you again. How are you?
I'm good, Steve. It's great to see you again.
Yeah, it's been a few days, and that's because you've got more results out, which is really positive. And we'll talk about the results in just a second. But you've completed now this, I want to call it a mini program at the Columba Silver Project in Mexico. A mini program with really important work that you're doing on the project. So let's remind everyone a little bit about this little drill program.
Yeah, so it was a 3,000 meter 12 hole program focused on what we call the D vein on the Columba Project. And of course, the Columba Project is an emerging vein district, and we've drilled now 147 holes there in total on numerous different veins, and we're getting really excellent grades and widths on a number of those veins. And the D vein is so far the standout, and we had a number of stellar holes there already, like 34 meters, a half kilo from the previous round of drilling, and then almost 30 meters of over 435 grams per ton as well. So we were just stepping off of these great intercepts to expand on the footprint of that in the D vein with this round we just finished up, this 12 holes.
Yeah, and you released the last two holes with results from, and again, just like you've seen in the past, they came out with some pretty strong numbers.
Yeah, great numbers. So like really great numbers. These were sort of the two easternmost holes heading toward another vein that it intersects a few hundred meters away and just left it wide open for expansion in that direction. And so we were hitting like 10 meters of over half a kilo and then over 8 meters of another half kilo in the other hole. And these are both within broader intercepts, the big fat intercepts of surrounding silver. In the one case, there's 17 meters of over 300 grams. So just a great result and bodes well for the resource potential in this project, which of course we're pretty bullish on.
Yeah, and that report's going to be coming out in the next little while, correct?
Well, we're looking for next year to come back in with an expanded program here of at least 20,000 meters. We think that'll be enough to get us to a resource by about the third quarter or beginning of the first or third quarter or beginning of the fourth quarter next year.
Yeah. So the key that, and I say that report coming out, meaning that you're going to be working on that, because you've said in the past that drilling is the most important thing. So there's still some gaps you want to fill in and things like that, right? Just so people understand that you just can't drop the report. There has to be the data in there to really support it.
Well, yeah, that's right. We have to do a lot more drilling. Like this zone is completely wide open. So you have to find how big it is, first of all. And then you have to get the drill density sufficient enough to be able to do a resource. So that's the work for next year. It's not just that vein, but there's other veins too that we're following up in a similar matter for to be able to come up with a maiden resource next year.
And Jim, is that what you explain to people that you talk to, is the fact that yeah, we're seeing good numbers in one vein, but there's a lot more on this particular project. And you and I have talked over the last couple of years about that and just the potential for it. So there's so much there and so much still yet to look at. So I'm sure you'd have to sort of remind everyone to just be patient with everything.
Well, yeah, it is. It's like it is a vein district, and it's almost completely hidden. It barely shows itself through erosion. So it's really interesting that way. And it's of a scale where we think the potential there exceeds 100 million ounces of silver. It's a similar scale of districts in Mexico that are well known of that size or multiples of that size. So we've got these structures pretty well mapped at surface. We know where most of them are. Some don't come to surface, so they're blind. And it's a matter of like systematically drilling now. And let's see how big this thing gets.
Yeah, and we'll be back in January to drill. Is that the idea?
Well, we'll be back in the first quarter, starting sometime in the first quarter. Yeah.
All right. Sounds good. All right, Jim, thank you so much. Happy holidays, my friend. Good update. And we'll talk to you very soon. Okay.
Yeah, very good. And Merry Christmas and happy holidays to you.
All right, good stuff. Jim McDonald, the CEO of Kootenay Silver.